Speaking about the positives after the Australia Grand Prix, we think we have found a good performance of our car in the cornering with a good corner speed. We have also seen that we were lacking a bit of top speed and struggling to attempt to overtake of other cars on the track. To prepare the next Malaysia and Bahrain races, the team has been checking, first of all, quite carefully all the data after the Australian Grand Prix to try to understand where we haven't got the most from the two cars. Then we have been doing some specific work considering the characteristics of the next tracks, the temperature that will found, the tires that will be available, essentially. Globally, we can say that the F14C potential expressed is just a part of the what can be achieved with developing it further and in detail. Going in every weekend, we try to get the most on the track, using the most that is available. But globally, there is margin to improve our performance level more than the recent years. Considering reliability, for us, is always the more important factor. Without a reliable car, you cannot really succeed in winning titles. Said that, we try always to improve our performance level, trying to respect the reliability constraint. Sepang is a very difficult track for having a lot of high-speed corners, so aerodynamics is a key factor, as always. It's also a track where generally, in average, we've been experiencing high temperatures, so cooling and reliability will be an important factor as well. And as well, we need to adapt to the new tires that will be available for this track.
The aerodynamics of Formula One are essentially governed by two main parameters, downforce and drag. A Formula One car is effectively the opposite of a fighter jet. In the case of a plane, the air pulls the plane up and thus keeps it flying. In the case of a Formula One car instead, the air pulls the car on the ground and hence it can go much faster around the corners. The downforce that a Formula One car produces is huge. With that, it can go around corners much faster than any other car. And together with a very efficient braking system, it can also decelerate much more rapidly than any other vehicle. The main instrument of development of aerodynamics is the wind tunnel. It's essentially a big tube. On the one side of the tube, there's a fan which moves the air around. On the other side is the working section. In there, there's a rolling road on which we position a model, which is 60% of the real car. The wind tunnel is indispensable for the design of a competitive Formula One car. It would be impossible to design a car that can compete without the use of a very, very good wind tunnel. In fact, the FIA has recently limited the number of runs one can do per week to 80. That is in order to reduce costs of Formula One. It has become indispensable to be able to choose which 80 runs to do with very great attention so that we don't waste runs on components that possibly could not work, and therefore we can maximize aerodynamic performance. The wind tunnel is pretty accurate. It does represent a lot of conditions of the real car as it goes around the track, but it's not perfect. Therefore, there's a degree of correlation that has to be achieved between the wind tunnel and the track, and that is also achieved together with some track measurements. One of the instruments that help us design a better car is CFD. It's a technique whereby a Formula One car aerodynamics is simulated by computers. With CFD, we get a lot more detail about the flow, and therefore we can be much more careful with how we design components and make a much better guess at what's going to work before taking a component to the wind tunnel.